Welcome, welcome everyone. I'm Ava and this is the Strong for Life Car Seat Safety Lab. So far, we've discussed both the ins and outs of rear-facing car seats and forward-facing car seats, but there's still one more stop on your child's car seat journey before they can ride with just a seatbelt. That's the humble booster seat. Ah, booster seats. Your little one graduating to one of these is a surefire sign that they're growing up. You're so close to having them out of car seats altogether, but you're not out of the woods yet. And listen, your kids are gonna be antsy. They want out of their booster seats as much as you want them to be done with it. And they're gonna for sure try to convince you that they're ready to be done with car seats. But until they hit the height or weight requirements, it's super important to keep them safe and snug in a booster. And where can you find said height and weight requirements? Do I even need to say it? You gotta read the manual. I mean, I know I'm pretty great, but I can only do so much. Booster seats generally come in two varieties, high back and no back. We'll save the particulars of both types for another video, but for now, there are just three things you need to know about them. One, every child should start in a high back booster seat, and as they grow, they can transition into a no back booster seat, so long as the car they're riding in has high enough seats and or a headrest to protect their head and neck. Two, the type of booster seat you'll use depends on your little one's height and weight needs, as well as their particular car habits. Example, does a car ride equal nap time for your kid? If so, you might want to stick with a high back booster seat for that extra side support and impact protection. Three, both types are installed in the forward-facing position using a lap and shoulder seatbelt to fasten your child in. And just like that, you're up to speed on all the top-level info about booster seats. If you're ready for a deep dive into the differences between high back versus no back booster seats, or want a rundown of booster seats' do's and don'ts, well, you know where to click. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a little light reading to catch up on.